So we will explore the sums of squares hypothesis a little bit more. And here we have a joint hypothesis where we set all betas simultaneously to zero. But these are not all the betas in the regression as we had in the last example, but just a subset of them. This is the most common hypothesis for an F-test or joint hypothesis in linear regression. And the example data here is housing data for Kitchener-Waterloo. And we regress housing list price on floor space, so a measure of house size, and the basement type. Basement type has four different levels: finished, none, partially, and unfinished. And which one am I leaving out here? Probably finished. So 94 observations. Here is the proposed regression model. Y, the price, is a function of indicators of the basement, none, partial, unfinished. So I left out the finished one. And then floor space and the epsilon as usual. To avoid very large coefficients, we give the house prices in $100,000. And so that a predicted price of five means that the house costs $500,000. This is purely to avoid large coefficients. Nothing changes here. So we run the regression of price on indicator variables for basement and floor space. And it so happens that the variable that status throws out is the first one, which is the one we want to throw out in this case. We choose to throw out. So we have three indicators in the floor space. The sums of squares residual is here, highlighted in red. And now we need to calculate the sums of squares residuals for the alternative model. This is the full model. And now we are going to compute the one for the alternative reduced model. But before we do that, we have a question. What is the coefficient of the baseline category? There are five possible answers, and I will leave you to answer this question and move on to the next slide. So the hypothesis is that these three things equal zero. The alternative is at least one of these betas does not equal zero. Under the null hypothesis, the reduced model is, well, if beta this is zero and this, we can throw these three things out. And we are left with the model that only has, well, intercept and floor space in the model. Okay, so now we run a regression just on floor space. And we get a different sums of squares here. This sums of squares needs to be larger or must be larger because we have fewer variables to explain the variation. And so there's more variation left over, so the residual sums of squares will be larger. Okay, now we have two sums of squares. We subtract one from the other. This is from the output. Divide by the degrees of freedom. We are setting three variables to zero, so it's three. And we're getting sigma squared from the output for the full model. Yeah, that's also in the ANOVA table. We do some calculations, and that's 0.9. Now, the question is that large? And whether it's large depends on the distribution of the statistic under the null hypothesis. But we already kind of know that we are comparing two estimates of sigma squareds. And this is the regular estimate. So if the estimate under the null hypothesis isn't even as large, is a little smaller than the regular estimate, we probably don't have a lot of evidence here to reject. So either way, we'll get to that in a second. For now, we're going to look at the question, What are the degrees of freedom for the F tests? You have to go back and look at the number of observations. And we have 3 in the numerator. And the question is, what's in the denominator? Okay, moving on. So the probability of exceeding the value 0.9, so less than 1 even, is quite large. It's 0.44, so 44%. So we don't have any reason to reject the null hypothesis. And therefore, we conclude, yes, we can set all of these 3 coefficients to 0, and the simpler model just does as well. A sanity check, if we want it, is to run the same thing on the on software. So Stata allows you to have a command called test, and then it says we are testing that the second, the third, and the fourth coefficient equals to 0, so they're all equals to 0. So it translates here. So this just repeats a command here, translates what it thinks that means. And we find out we get the same probability, 43%. Okay, subject to rounding error, but other than that, it's the same. Good, which leaves us with another clicker question here. We have output, and I mentioned last time that this F corresponds to the hypothesis that all of the coefficients belonging to the variables here are jointly 0. So all of them are 0, except for the constant, of course. So the question is, what is the corresponding F value that I've hidden here? So you see the output runs off the side on purpose, so we can see, so you can compute this. And I will leave you to answer this question. You have 5 different options.